Today we're going to discuss the relationship between Mohr graphs and cages. We'll start with the discussion of the degree diameter problem, from which we'll move on to Mohr graphs, and then to a special type of graph known as a cage. Finally, we'll look at the connection between Mohr graphs and cages, and how we can extend the idea of a Mohr graph to graphs with even girth. Let's talk about the degree diameter problem now. The problem is to find the graph with the most vertices with a maximum degree d and diameter k. Intuitively, if you create increasingly large graphs while not allowing their maximum degree to increase, you will eventually get a really sparse graph with a high diameter and vertices far away from each other. Similarly, if you create increasingly large graphs while not allowing their diameter to increase, you will eventually have to raise the maximum degree in order to prevent diameter from increasing. So the degree diameter problem asks us, if we restrict the maximum degree to be less than or equal to a number d, and restrict the diameter to be k, just how big can we make our graph? It turns out that there's an upper bound, known as the Mohr bound, for how many vertices a graph with max degree d and diameter k can have. Let's take a look at how this bound was discovered. Think about the tree formed by breadth-first search on any vertex, v, in a graph with max degree d and diameter k. The first thing to notice is that we cannot have more than k plus 1 total levels, because our graph has diameter k. Next, the level 0 has one vertex, v, and level 1 has at most d vertices, all adjacent to v. Level 2 has at most d times d minus 1 vertices, as each of the d vertices in level 1 can be adjacent to at most d minus 1 vertices in level 2, since the maximum allowable degree is d. Generalizing, in the level n, we'll have at most d times d minus 1 to the n minus 1 vertices. This means we can count the number of vertices in levels 1 through k with this sum, with a total number of vertices being one more than that sum, as level 0 has one vertex. So this is our upper bound for the number of vertices in a graph with maximum degree d and diameter k. We don't know if, for a given choice of d and k, there exists a graph that actually attains the Mohr bound. It could be that, for whatever reason, we're not able to meet this upper bound for certain choices of d and k. What we do know is that no graph with maximum degree d and diameter k can have more vertices than this number. This leads us into Mohr graphs. A Mohr graph is a graph that does meet this upper bound. It's a graph with diameter k, maximum degree d, and exactly as many vertices as the Mohr bound for a graph with those parameters. Note that when this upper bound is reached, the girth of the graph will be 2k plus 1. As if it were greater than that, our diameter would have to be greater than k, and if it were less, a vertex's breadth-first search tree will have a level that is missing vertices, meaning the graph would not reach the Mohr bound. Also, our graph is necessarily regular with degree d. Mohr graphs are very rare. There are only a few cases of parameters of d and k that have or could have Mohr graphs. Let's look at some of the known Mohr graphs. For graphs with diameter 1 and maximum degree n, the complete graph on n plus 1 vertices is a Mohr graph. You can verify this by plugging in 1 for k in our formula for the Mohr bound. It does in fact evaluate to n plus 1 as our number of vertices. For graphs with diameter n and degree 2, the odd cycle with 2n plus 1 vertices is a Mohr graph. You can verify this by plugging in 2 for d in our formula for the Mohr bound, and checking that it does evaluate to 2n plus 1 as our number of vertices. We've just described two infinite families of Mohr graphs. But once our parameters move a little higher, Mohr graphs get much rarer. Aside from the cycle graphs, it's been proven that there are no Mohr graphs with diameter greater than or equal to 3. Additionally, for graphs with diameter 2, we know that the only choices of degrees that allow for a Mohr graph are 2, 3, 7, and 57. Three of these have been found. The Moore graph with diameter 2 and degree 2 is the odd cycle with 5 vertices. The Moore graph with diameter 2 and degree 3 is the Peterson graph, which is shown here. The Moore graph with diameter 2 and degree 7 is the Hoffman-Singleton graph, shown here. Now, up until last year, it was unknown whether a Moore graph existed with degree 57 and diameter 2. However, its existence seems to have been disproven last year. I posted the paper in the description. I mentioned at the start of the video that we discuss cages and their relationship to Moore graphs, so let's do that now. First, we'll need the concept of an RG graph. An RG graph is a graph whose vertices all have degree R and whose shortest cycle has length G. Next, let's define cages. An RG cage is the RG graph with the fewest vertices. It's the smallest graph with a given girth and degree. Now, it's known that there exists a cage for any choice of parameters R and G, as long as R is at least 2 and as long as G is at least 3. We'll look at this in depth in a future video, but for now, let's think about this question. What's the theoretically least possible number of vertices for an RG graph? The answer, if we can find it, will give us a lower bound for the number of vertices in an RG cage. To construct our lower bound, we can again use a kind of breadth-first search approach, but we have to do this process separately for graphs with odd and even girth. Starting with a lower bound for RG graphs with odd girth, let's begin our breadth-first search at any vertex V in our R regular graph with odd girth 2k plus 1. V must be adjacent to R other vertices, which will be in level 1. And notice that no vertex in level 1 can be adjacent to any other vertex in level 1 if k was greater than 1, because that would imply the existence of a cycle shorter than the girth of our graph, which is not allowed. So, every vertex has to have r-1 additional neighbors to go into the second level of our graph. Also, no vertex can be adjacent to more than one vertex in the level above it, because then we would have an even cycle of length shorter than our graph's girth, 2k plus 1. Together, these restrictions mean that as long as our level comes at or before level k, we're forced to add levels that are as full as they can be. That is, each level will have r-1 times as many vertices as the previous level, and no intra-level edges. Eventually, we reach level k. In the best case, when we reach our theoretical lower bound for number of vertices, this will be our last level. It's at this level that there might be vertices in the same level that are adjacent to each other. These adjacencies produce our cycles of length 2k plus 1. Again, in the best possible case, we might be able to add enough intra-level edges in this final level so that we don't have to add another level in order to fulfill the degree requirements of the vertices in this final level. Note that each vertex in this final level will have to be adjacent to r-1 other vertices in this final level. How many vertices do we have in total? It'll be this sum, which looks familiar. That's because this is the expression for the Moore bound for graphs with max degree r and diameter k. Now remember that Moore graphs with max degree r and diameter k are regular graphs with girth 2k plus 1. So if we have a Moore graph with max degree r and diameter k, that same graph must be a r 2k plus 1 cage, as it has the fewest possible number of vertices for a regular graph with its degree r and girth 2k plus 1. Interestingly, this means that all Moore graphs are cages. Before we get to the lower bound for the number of vertices in a cage of even girth, let's extend the definition of a Moore graph to include graphs with even girth. Instead of defining a Moore graph as the graph that attains the theoretically maximum number of vertices given a diameter and maximum degree, we can instead define a Moore graph to be the regular graph that attains the theoretically minimum number of vertices given a degree and girth. All the more graphs that we got from the degree diameter perspective are still more graphs from this perspective. They're just the odd girth cases. Now let's find the lower bound for number of vertices in a regular graph with even girth. This will be our more bound for graphs with even girth. Suppose we have a regular graph with girth 2k and degree r. Now choose a vertex from this graph and call it V. V must be adjacent to r other vertices. Moving on, just as for the odd girth case, no vertex in levels prior to level k can be adjacent to any other vertex in its level, or else we would have a cycle with length smaller than this graph's girth, 2k. So, we know that we must have at least levels 2 through k-1 as full as possible, each level with r-1 times as many vertices as the previous level. Now, once we reach level k-1, we still have no cycles, so there must be more vertices to add. But before we add them, let's count the number of vertices we have so far. It's the same as it was for the odd girth case up until this point in the BFS tree. Returning to our breadth-first search, our vertices in level k-1 are still missing r-1 neighbors each. And again, there are no cycles yet. r-1 to the k-1, which is 1 over r times the number of vertices in level k-1, is the least number of vertices that could form an additional level, level k, to ensure the girth is 2k and all the vertices have degree r. This would require that each vertex in level k is adjacent to exactly r vertices in level k-1. So, let's add r-1 to the k-1 to our current count of vertices to get the following total for our lower bound of vertices in regular graphs of degree r and even girth 2k. Note that this lower bound is not always attainable. It could take more vertices than what we have here, but this is the lower bound. We can now define the more graph with even girth 2k and degree r to be any graph with even girth 2k and degree r that has the exact number of vertices given by our more bound. Using our new definition, we can say that the more graph with degree 3 and girth 4 is the complete bipartite graph K3, as it has the number of vertices, 6, given by our lower bound for graphs with even girth 4 and degree 3. In general, the more graph with degree r and girth 4 is the complete bipartite graph K(R)R. It has also been shown that besides the trivial more graphs, the only more graphs are those for girth 5, 6, 8, or 12. We already took a look at the more graphs for girth 5. Here are a couple of the more graphs for higher even girth, 6 and 8. To finish the video, let's do a quick recap. More graphs are graphs that attain the upper bound for the number of vertices given a maximum degree and diameter. They end up being regular with girth one more than twice the diameter. On the other hand, cages are regular graphs that have the least number of vertices for their given degree and girth. As we saw in this video, all more graphs are cages, which lets us redefine more graphs to be cages whose number of vertices equals the lower bound for their girth and degree. Also, more graphs are very rare. For graphs with degree at least 3 and girth at least 5, only graphs with girth 5, 6, 8, or 12 could be more graphs. That's it for this video. In future videos, we'll take a deeper look at cages as well as hypergraphs. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please subscribe. Have a great day.